Hi, Frida. So, G-Dog, this is a documentary about one of the most important people in talking about rehabilitation of ex-gang members, right?
Exactly. And what he is actually most respected for and liked is that he really was very groundbreaking and innovative and dealing with young people at risk. Oftentimes, maybe they haven't spent time in jail, but they're ready to go practically because they're on the streets, maybe typically at 11, 12, 13, looking probably for some connection and family, and they find it in gangs. Because often you hear their background. It's a typical portrait of dysfunction, you know, domestic violence, drugs. You know, they come out of that kind of, most of them, you ask them, they have that kind of background. They're looking for something else that they didn't get at home. And as Father G says, or Greg says, no hopeful kid joins a gang. Mm-hmm. They're looking, and what he's created is, in a sense, the family that they didn't have. Because besides all the programs, you know, I mean, the basic philosophy is nothing stops a bullet like a job. So the kids come in who say they want to change, and they start off by getting, you know, basic, they're hired to do sort of basic work in the bakery. They have five social enterprises, you know, a printing shop, a bakery, silkscreen, retail store, homegirl cafe, and they start to learn the basic responsibilities of an employee. You know, they learn to clock in, and they take all kinds of, you know, educational things, anything they need to both prepare them psychologically and emotionally and give them strength so they can go off after 18 months there.
And how do you pick this subject matter? Why focusing your project on this specific program?
Well, actually, I was intrigued by the idea of a Jesuit priest who was dealing with gangs or former gang members. And I read a really small blurb about a book called Tattoos in the Heart. And it said, Jesuit priest, gang members, and unconditional love. That was, for him, the ultimate solution. I mean, jobs help, mental health programs help, tattoo removal helps, yoga helps, but ultimately, it's really kinship and basic love, he felt, is what would give them the strength to go forward. I think most kids who come up in normal families, privileged families, we call it, you know, just have that basic part of their upbringing. Someone loves them unconditionally. Mm-hmm. So it just intrigued me. I wasn't looking for the issue of gangs. I was just curious about what is this priest doing, you know? And I think that's what actually people are intrigued by, a Jesuit priest dealing with former gang members.
What was the biggest challenge making the documentary?
Biggest challenge was just let me think. Figuring out how I was going to make it to finish it, actually. You know, I try not to worry about, you know, the downside. And it actually was quite a blessed project. I don't know. A lot of people wanted to be a part of this film, partly because of him. He's just an amazing human being, and he just brought out the best in all of us. You know, and so a lot of people wanted to help. And you know, I started this project as a kind of a passion project, a leap of faith. You know, I didn't, you know, sometimes I would raise, you know, money for a project. It was going so fast that friends just said, no, we'd love to just work on the project.
So what is your expectation? I mean, people, after watching the movie, you would like them to think differently about gang members, about Latinos, about...
Well, there are actually, it's an equal opportunity gang rehabilitation because there are Asian gang members and there are blacks and there are Latinos. It started off actually with primarily Latino because Father Boyle was assigned to a parish in the barrio. He wanted to work with poor people, so he was assigned to this place in L.A., Dolores Mission, was the poorest parish in California. You know, and he thought he was just going to work with the poor, but he actually didn't realize he was walking into the gang capital of the country. The biggest, greatest gang numbers of kids and violence was occurring around, you know, within a mile of the parish. This was about 20 years ago, and things were pretty tough in L.A. with the police and the and the communities were in an armed camp, you know, just hated each other, one another. You know, it was just, it's changed a lot, you know. And he was very controversial. I mean, the police didn't like him. The archdiocese didn't like him because he was very unconventional. He really basically put a human face on who are gang members, you know. And he really made people try to think about this as a very complex issue. It's not that they're bad kids, but it's actually a result of a lot of social issues of poverty, dysfunction, joblessness, you know. And what gangs are for him, and I think for me and for him, the idea is that hopefully we'll understand. Coming out of this film, I hope you're entertained and moved, but also you kind of, you know, are enlightened about a social issue that is a community issue. They're part of our community, you know. It's a public safety issue, and it's also a social issue. Because they're all, you know, gangs that, kids at risk are a part of who we are, you know. So.
Do you already know what's
I knew nothing about that, by the way. I had no, nothing. So it's been an interesting journey. Makes me want to, you know, do my part to help out, you know, volunteer, do some things, yeah.
Do you already know what's going to be your next project, or?
I'm finishing another project, a feature documentary like this one, and it's, in this country, she's famous. It's a woman named Anita Hill. She's the one who kind of jump-started the awareness, public awareness about sexual harassment. And she was subpoenaed to testify about a Supreme Court justice nominee. He's on the Supreme Court now, Clarence Thomas. Just as he was about to be confirmed, she testified that, you know, he basically was grossly sexually harassing her. And very graphic testimony. People were riveted to the television set. So it's kind of a cultural phenomenon in this country. But also it's an international issue, if you think of patriarchal societies and women, all those, yeah.
And last question, do you think that documentaries, they have a responsibility to tackle these kind of tough subjects, or?
Not really, no. I think, for me, I think it depends on why you do documentaries. I like to tell a story that happens to be nonfiction. Nonfiction lends itself to sometimes sort of serious ideas, but hopefully the way, you know, my films are designed, that it's also entertaining and it's an enjoyable experience. Yeah. But also you do maybe leave with something more than just, froth. Yeah.